we have gathered here to know about the reason why short run average cost curve is used. In economics, industry consists of several firms, and firm consists of several plant. It means plant is the unit of a firm, and firm is the unit of industry. When we discuss cost curve, we take a case of firm. Firm is reality. Each firm has cost schedule and revenue schedule. And the objective of the firm is to minimize cost of production. Objective of the firm is to maximize profit. So profit maximization and cost minimization, these are the dual objective of the firm. They will always try to minimize cost of production. This will increase the size of the profit. We all know that the cost of production is of two types, fixed cost and variable cost. Fixed cost is the land and capital, interest, capital. And variable cost is labor and entrepreneur. In the cost condition, we take rent, wage, interest, and profit. These are the rewards to the factors of production. All firms have to pay salary to the workers, interest to the bank, rent to the proprietor, and profit to the shareholders. So in the short run, in the starting period, demand is less. Therefore, firm produce less amount. That is less than the optimal size. That is less than the capacity of the plant. Because in the earlier period, demand is less. So when production is very low, then average variable cost and average fixed cost, both will be taken into account. Mr. John Robinson and Mr. Chamberlain, they have used cost concept in their monopolistic competition, and Mr. John Robinson in her imperfect competition analysis. Mr. John Robinson said that average cost is the sum of average fixed cost curve and average variable cost curve. If we will add these two curves with the help of vertical summation, we will get U-shaped average cost curve. Similarly, Chamberlain said that the average cost curve is U-shaped. Chamberlain takes average fixed cost as downward sloping and average variable cost as U-shaped. By adding these two, by vertical summation, we will get average cost curve U-shaped. In the diagram, we see here that in the short run average cost curve analysis, average variable cost is downward sloping. It means output increases, average variable cost decreases. This will continue till the optimum capacity of the plant. On the other hand, Mr. John Robinson said that average variable cost in the initial period will be constant, and when the plant capacity arrives, it will rise. Edward Chamberlain has given U-shape average variable cost. That average variable cost will decrease till it is minimum at the point of optimal utilization of the plant, and thereafter it will increase. Technique of getting you save average cost curve in mixing these two diagrams into one. Downward sloping average fixed cost and horizontal and upward sloping average variable cost. Adding these two distances, we find out that this is average variable cost, this is average fixed cost. Average fixed cost is greater and average variable cost is less in the initial period. And then by adding these two, we will get C1, that is average cost curve.
Yeah.
It means Q1, C1 is equal to Q1 A1 plus Q1 B1. Likewise, we will take Q2 C2, Q2 A2, Q2 B2, and finally Qn Cn, Qn An, Qn Vn. This is termed as vertical summation of average fixed cost and average variable cost curve. Vertical summation. And we get here U shaped cost curve according to Mrs. John Robinson. If we take average variable cost of the chamberlain and average fixed cost, then by the same technique we will derive average cost U shaped. What is the reason behind it? Look here in the board. Technical economies, managerial economies, marketing economies, financial economies, labor economies, transport economies, and these are converted into this economy. Now, we should analyze that why does shorten average cost curve is used. According to expert economists about the cost, they say that in initial period, economies are greater than this economy. In some factor there may be diseconomy, in some factor there may be economy. What is economy? What does it mean? Economy means per unit cost decreases. What is economy? What is technical economy? Per unit technical cost, per unit technical cost decreases as output increases, as output increases. This is called technical economy. Technical economy. And what is this economy? Per unit technical cost increases and production increases. It is called diseconomics, technical diseco. This economy. Similarly, managerial economies. What is managerial economy? per unit. Same definition, change the name. Per unit managerial cost. Managerial cost decreases and output increases. This is called managerial economy. What will be managerial diseconomy? Per unit cost increases and per unit cost increases and per unit managerial cost, per unit managerial cost increases as output increase. Similarly, financial economy. Financial economy. Per unit financial cost.